Okay, folks, so to begin our tutorial, we're going to have a look at the chords that we'll be using today. And here you can see I've already added the chords under the pad main channel. Let's have a look in the view channel rack. And here you can see where I've added the chords. And you can see I've actually used Serum for this sound. Let's have a listen to it first of all, and then we'll take a look a bit further in detail. Okay, so we have a very nice dreamy sort of pad sound, and this works very well for the track that we're working on. So let's now look at the chords. If we double click on the sound on the channel, then we can get into the piano roll, which will show us each of the keys that we've used to get the sound. So here you can see all of the keys. We have D3, F-sharp 3, D4, F-sharp 4, A4, and then we change it up a little bit. We have B2, A3, with the same top three keys. We have the same top three keys for our third, fourth, fifth bar. Okay, and then we have some changes here. So just take note of all of these keys, guys. And we want to add this to a channel with Serum. And then we're going to want to add that What About Emotive Melodic House Pad Chimes. This is from one of the packs available on What About Production on their website. So check it out, guys. Lots of great sounds there. Okay, and now let's have a look at the effects. So we're going to click into the mixer. And here we can see channel is assigned to number 9, to the mixer channel number 9. So let's click into the mixer. And here we can see we have some different effects. We have a multiband compressor. In the multiband compressor, we have slightly turned down the gain to around 11 o'clock. Then our midband until just below 12 o'clock, and same for the high band. We've also added in some stereo shaper. And the only thing that we've done here with the shaper, the fruity stereo shaper, we have selected the stereoized to preset. So not much to be done here. And again, fruity stereo shaper is built into Fruity Loops, guys. Also, we've added in sound goodizer. Again, that's another built-in one to Fruity Loops. And when we open up sound goodizer, we should have it to about here. Sound goodizer is very good for in really making the sound a lot more richer and a lot more warm. So that's why I added it in to the pads, because it really does complement them. We have also added in some EQing with the Fruity Parametric EQ2 tool. And we've just cut off from 63 Hertz. And everything else should be left the way it is. And finally, we have our filter, which we will go into later on. And we have also sent our pad channel to connect with our reverb channel. We have created a reverb channel where we can connect any of the other mixer channels to in order to give them that effect. So here we've also just altered the reverb slightly, made the size around 96. Diffusion we haven't touched. The speed should be 33%, the delay 70 ms, and we have 150% for the bass, 4.5 seconds delay time for DEC, yes. And for the cross, it should be 298 hertz. And for the damp, it should be 3.1. We also worked on the dry and the ER and wet, adjusting them slightly. So the dry should be 84%. And 100% for the early reflection level, and for the wet level, 91%. And that's all the adjustments we've done for our chords, for our main pad sound. Now let's move on to adding some extra sounds, guys, and building this track up. Okay, so now that we have our main chords for the track, we're going to work on adding some extra sounds. So as you can see here, we've already added pad main plus the pluck sound. So let's give this a play and see how it sounds. Okay, so very nice pluck that we've added in there. Let's have a look at it. So we're going to select View Channel Rack. And here you can see the pluck that we've added. It's actually from a VST from What About Production called ImPerfect. So you can find more about this on their website. And we've used one of the factory sounds called Factory 1 Pluck 07. And we haven't really done much to the sound as it was good to go. If you go into the mixer channel, the mixer, we can see that it's assigned to Mixer Effects Channel 9. Which is also the same as the pad channel. In this case, most of these sounds, most of these effects really work well for the sound that we're using. So it definitely worked better to have them both in the matching channel. So that is our main pluck sound. Now let's have a look at the keys that we used. Another good trick, guys, is if you have a pluck, or if you're adding a pluck to your track and you already have your pads, if you add it to the same channel, then you will be able to see all of the other sounds, all the other keys in the piano roll. So for example, we have these two sounds both in the same channel rack. If we click into the piano roll again, you can see the grayed out keys are actually the pad sound keys. So that really helps us keep in line whenever we are making our pluck sounds. So it's a great way to keep the keys in line. So that's about it for our pluck sound. Now we're going to continue to build on our track, guys.